the seeds of Mahatma Gandhi's vision, People Building Peace, are being nurtured in India in a school called City Montessori School, popularly known as CMS. Established in 1959 with 5 pupils and the founders Drs. Jagdish and Bharati Gandhi as first teachers, today in its strength of nearly 55,000 students, with its name in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest school by pupils, CMS also stands out because of its philosophy till today of its efforts to promote the universal values of education for peace and tolerance at a time when these values are increasingly being challenged. CMS has been awarded the UNESCO Prize for Peace Education in 2002, thereby becoming the world's first school recipient of this prestigious award in the award's history. Every activities of Dr. Gandhi have shown how parents and society can be involved, motivated, and molded to become partners for positive change in the lives of children. It is for this same reason that Dr. Gandhi convenes the international conferences of the chief justices of the world that aims to create a common enforceable international law to safeguard the future of the world's now 2.5 billion children and generations yet to be born. Ever since, 1,002 chief justices and judges, heads of state or governments from 125 countries have participated in previous 17 conferences. The world is yet again on the brink. The prospect of a nuclear confrontation between the United States and North Korea, reminiscent of the Cold War of the last century. It is at this juncture, the 18th International Conference of Chief Justices of the World on Article 51 of the Constitution of India, the World Peace Congress 2017, called by City Montessori School for the safety of world's nearly 2.5 billion children and generations yet to be born, is relevant. To hold discussions, share concerns, and to build consensus for world unity and peace, Vice President of Guyana, Mr. Khemraj Ramjathan, Prime Minister of Lesotho, Mr. B. Mosilili, Governor General of Tuvalu, Mr. Iacoba T. Italili, former President of Croatia, Mr. Stejepan Mejic, President of the Parliament of Mauritius, Mrs. Shantibai Hanumanji, President of the Parliament of Ghana, Professor Aaron Mike Okaye, former Chief Minister of the Sabaragamuwa Province of Sri Lanka, Mr. Mahipala Herat, judges from the Court of Netherlands, Justice Ibe OCG and Justice Anthony Kesia MB Mendua, and around 200 Chief Justices, judges, members of the judiciary and world peace promoters from 60 countries arrived at New Delhi, India. On the 8th morning, the August guests went to visit the UNESCO World Heritage Site, the Taj Mahal at Agra. In the evening, the guests could experience a peaceful spiritual journey at the Baha'i place of worship in New Delhi, the Lotus Temple.
The basic purpose of all the religion is to safeguard the interest and promote the unity of the human race and to foster the spirit of love and fellowship amongst men.
On the ninth morning, founder manager of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, who was also the convener of this International Conference of Chief Justices of the World, and his team from the World Unity Education Department accompanied all the guests to Rajghat to offer floral tribute to Mahatma Gandhi at Gandhi Samadhi. Gandhi's ideals had a tremendous intellectual impact on the founding fathers of the new India, who incorporated many of his convictions into the directive principles of state policy. Internationally, Gandhi expressed ideals few can reject. Universal peace, which Gandhi considered so central to truth, seems as illusionary as ever. Yet, a school in Lucknow, CMS, is trying keeping Gandhi and his values of universal peace sown and cherished in young hearts. While the world was integrating into fascism, violence, and war, Gandhi taught the virtues of truth, non-violence, and peace. In the afternoon, a press conference was held at Le Meridien in the presence of the chief guest, Union Minister of Home Affairs, Government of India, Shri Rajnath Singh.
We are extremely proud and privileged to welcome our most honored chief guest, Honorable Shri Rajnath Singh, the Home Minister of India. Simple and unassuming, with immense love for the humanity, he believes in the philosophy of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The whole Vasudha, the whole earth, is our own family. The family should live in peace, harmony and unity. That he believes in. We are all honored to have Honorable Shri Rajnath Singh, the beloved Home Minister of India, the senior most minister of the Government of India, as our chief guest at the first session of the Chief Justices Conference, which is being held here in Le Meridien.
I had the proud privilege of welcoming you to the first session of this very important international conference of the Chief Justices of the world. I congratulate the founder manager of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, and the staff and students of the school who had made this great effort of uniting the world leadership that has to work together for ensuring that their future generations have a safe and secure future. Our government is committed to working for peace and security, not only for the people of India and the subcontinent, but also that of the entire world. Every effort that our country has made under the able and dynamic leadership of our Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi is aimed at building a better future for the people everywhere. The recent progress that our country has made in nearly all fields of development He speaks volumes for the quality and commitment of our leadership, enterprise and expertise. Dear friends, I believe that there is a growing realization amongst the majority of the world's nations that we all share a common future as the problems we face are not confined to man-made boundaries, and thus we have to collectively find solutions to our problems ourselves. Therefore, this conference, being organized on the Article 51 of the Constitution of India with the theme of uniting the world for children through enforceable world law and effective global governance, is all the more important. I am certain that your participation here will send out a positive message to all the leaders of the world and will motivate them to come together on a common platform and work towards our common goal of world unity and world peace to ensure a safe future for our children and generations yet to be born.
A high tea in the honor of the visiting dignitaries was organized, where the chief guest was the Union Minister for Law and Justice, Government of India, Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad.
Our proud privilege to welcome Honorable Sri Ravi Shankar Prasad, the most respected Law Minister of India, who has very kindly organized this reception in honor of Honorable Chief Justices and Judges who have come from 60 countries of the world to participate in the 18th International Conference of Chief Justices of the World.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is very good that you congregate to celebrate the diversity of the world. And you also congregate to reiterate the world coming together. Very briefly, I would like to outline some of the India's story which has impressed the world and which can be also replicated in other parts. India as a country has a recorded history of 8,000 to 10,000 years. A country of great civilization, of great cultural heritage, some of the finest books of human creativity like Vedas and Upanishads were written thousands of years ago. The book like Bhagavad Gita still retains the best of what the human mind can think. And this cultural tradition of India has led to a great unifying factor in the country. India has only 26 constitutionally recognized languages. All the religions of the world, Hinduism is the predominant, we have Christianity, we have Islam, we have Zoroastrian, we have Buddhism, we have Jainism, Sikhism, you name. All the religions of the world have a place in India. And just Mr. Gandhi talked of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. But the other equally important philosophical underpinning of India is Bahujan Hitaya, Bahujan Sukhaya. We pray for the happiness of all. We pray for the development of all. That has been our motto.
Till they reach the sky, CMS is
seeds of Mahatma Gandhi's vision, People Building Peace, are being nurtured in India in a school called City Montessori School, popularly known as CMS. Established in 1959 with 5 pupils and the founders Drs. Jagdish and Bharati Gandhi as first teachers, today in its strength of nearly 55,000 students, with its name in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest school by pupils, CMS also stands out because of its philosophy till today of its efforts to promote the universal values of education for peace and tolerance at a time when these values are increasingly being challenged. CMS has been awarded the UNESCO Prize for Peace Education in 2002, thereby becoming the world's first school recipient of this prestigious award in the award's history. Every activities of Dr. Gandhi have shown how parents and society can be involved, motivated, and molded to become partners for positive change in the lives of children. It is for this same reason that Dr. Gandhi convenes the international conferences of the Chief Justices of the world that aims to create a common enforceable international law to safeguard the future of the world's now 2.5 billion children and generations yet to be born. Ever since, 1,002 Chief Justices and judges, heads of state or governments from 125 countries have participated in previous 17 conferences. The world is yet again on the brink. The prospect of a nuclear confrontation between the United States and North Korea, reminiscent of the Cold War of the last century. It is at this juncture, the 18th International Conference of Chief Justices of the World on Article 51 of the Constitution of India, the World Peace Congress 2017, called by City Montessori School for the safety of world's nearly 2.5 billion children and generations yet to be born, is relevant. To hold discussions, share concerns, and to build consensus for world unity and peace. The resolution, also known as the Lucknow Declaration, was then officially released to the media by the delegates at a press conference.
I want to say that I am extraordinarily impressed by the fact, and this is important because it's a significant development here, that a non-governmental organization, a citizens association, a school, private organization, has managed to mobilize a conference of global significance with global issues at its primary points, and having, secondly, the capacity to merge at a very high level members of the judiciary with school children of 9th to 11th grade and even younger grades than that, so that we can see a very collaborative effort from the high quality of judicial officers measuring up to what the children want to know about on matters that have global significance. Those are the two significant points that I see here, because ordinarily we find that big judicial conferences are only arranged by governments or some international world organization. But what we have seen here is the masterful skills of the founder of Montessori School and its teachers and students organizing such a wonderful conference in which some very important topics, establishing the rule of law, sustainable development, and so many other things. And I am very impressed, very much impressed. I believe our world, with this kind of personnel arranging conferences of this nature, are in safe hands.
I'm highly impressed of the organization of this important conference of the physicists of the world, and also the hospitality, perfect organized, the organizers, the founder and Gandhi's family, all of them, and the city, the people, the citizens of Lucknow. And we hope that we are keen every year to attend this conference, because on the article of number 51 of the Constitution of India. Thank you very much for the hospitality, the reception, and good
day.
I hope this conference bring peace, peace message to the entire world. And I really appreciate the hard working of dear Dr. Ish Gandhi.
What we must do is a concerted effort by all the citizens.
आज विश्व की समस्या है टेरिटोरियल वार, विश्व बचेगा कि रहेगा, इसको बचाने का केवल एक उपाय है, और वो है वर्ल्ड की पार्लियामेंट, वर्ल्ड की गवर्नमेंट, वर्ल्ड कोर्ट ऑफ जस्टिस, और यही प्रस्ताव हमारे चीफ जस्टिस द्वारा जजों ने चार दिन के मंथन के बाद जो प्रस्ताव पारित किया है वो आज आपको बांट दिया गया है। उस प्रस्ताव में यही उन्होंने कहा है कि विश्व की ऐसी ऐसी बड़ी समस्याएं हैं, इनका निदान किसी इंडिविजुअल राष्ट्र के पास नहीं है। कहने का तात्पर्य होड़ लगी हुई है, अधिक से अधिक धन हम बमों के निर्माण में खर्च कर रहे हैं, इसको रोकने की जरूरत है, और ये तभी रुकेगा जब एकता हो।
In a culture of peace. This is very important. We can change the world if we begin the work with children.
Why do chief justices keep coming to this conference when during the conference they argue that they cannot make law, they cannot change governments? I think they keep on coming to this conference because they realize that there is a world issue deserving of their attention, and they want to be part of the solution.
I felt like never before as an internationalist, as a person who is part of this struggle for a better world, being among so many people from all over the world, my fellow colleagues, justices, that believe in the future, that believe in peace, that believe as education as essential for building a better future. Thank you very much.
They have given us a living experience to see their, magnificent educational curriculum and the way they have managed to raise children amounting up to 50,000 something, 53,000 at a time, taking them to a different world.
एकजुट होकर के जो प्रयास हम करेंगे उससे जरूरन शांति आएगी और समृद्धि बढ़ेगी।
The chief justices and judges from all over the world unanimously stated that the conference organized by City Montessori School, Lucknow, was a historic conference that would definitely help the future generations. The judges vowed that they will carry this mission to their respective countries and take it further with the help of their governments to establish a world government, a world parliament, a world currency, and an effective world judicial system. rights must be exercised for justice. Convener of the conference, Dr. Gandhi, backed by Team CMS, has once again exercised its rights, raising voice for the safeguarding of the future of our children by passing the resolution, offering solutions that, if implemented by the countries through formation of the World Government, World Parliament with World Currency and World Court of Justice, will ensure the safety of our planet. Jai Jagat.
शिक्षात्मक सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम एवं चिंतन हेतु विश्व एकता सत्संग में आप सभी सपरिवार सादर आमंत्रित हैं।